over the last almost 3 years now, the Scientific Advisory Board has debated on big data and data revolution, on the framework for science policy interface and science advice, on the importance of co-production of science and local and indigenous people. The Scientific Advisory Board has now pronounced twice on climate change and climate risk assessment, and are right now also finalizing a brief on the importance of food and health nexus.
Local and indigenous knowledge is critical. We must pay special attention to the needs of developing countries and the most vulnerable. I am so honored by the service of such eminent scientists and social scientists. Thank you for your engagement and commitment. I count on you to continue supporting member states in reaching their goals.
Sustainable development requires looking at every aspect of human societies, human decision-making, the underlying ecosystems that they operate on, natural systems that they operate on. So shifting the human trajectory towards genuinely sustainable development requires insights from all of those fields. It's not something any particular discipline is able to get very far with on its own.
We have to react globally. This is with different issues, and infectious diseases is a very good example, of course. The microbes, they act globally, and they are clever, and also we as human beings, we have to do the same.
For human health, risk is a very serious issue. For climate, for the health of the planet, still policymakers do not understand how serious this issue is.
Understanding, are we really making progress in terms of sustainable development? Are we really leaving no one behind? We cannot know that unless the communities themselves are part of the process and part of the decision making.
I would like to first of all congratulate the Secretary General of the United Nations for having the initiative to create this scientific advisory board.
Profound human challenges remain in food production, clean water, healthcare, energy, climate change, and urbanization.
So there is a need to increase the support of science and also to do and develop programs.
And it is in this spirit that I'm pleased to express to all of you my warmest wishes for a very productive and successful meeting.
We had a public event today because it's also very important that the SAAB members can interact with the general public, so not only with policymakers or scientists, but also taking questions from people, particularly also from young students.
My wish, of course, is that policymaking would pay attention to the voice of science, but also create a working mechanism for how science voice can continually be heard in the highest forum of decision making.